Hello, everybody, and thank you so much for your time once again this evening. You know, this is the place to be every Friday. One-on-one is our hashtag. Please start tweeting. We've got two mega stars in studio tonight. At Maurice Kiria, that's his Twitter handle. You can start talking to him on Twitter. And also at Young Scales, that's the other artist's Twitter handle. You can start talking to him as well right away. Always in studio every Friday, the man that helps bring the house down, DJ Crossfade, is on the decks. And I'll be getting into a conversation shortly with this mega, super talented gentleman from Kampala, Uganda. He's not new to you. You probably see him for his amazing videos. He's been in Kenya quite a bit, and we'll be talking to him shortly. That's Maurice Kiria. And of course, from Lagos, Nigeria, is Young Scales is his Twitter handle, but he goes by the name Scales, and we'll be talking to him very shortly as well. Let me not talk too much. Let me let these gentlemen do what they do best.
Take a lifetime for us to be over, sweet baby. Heaven will sing when we have each other. You don't have to fear, 'cause I will make you feel. I will make you feel like you've never been loved before. 'Cause I'll give you love like you've never been loved before. I will make you feel like you've never been loved before. 'Cause I will give you love like you've never been loved.
London. All the blessings and love by the sea, just to make me they shout hallelujah. I say all the blessings and love by the sea, just to make me they shout hallelujah. They hold me for ransom, cause I'm young and I'm rich and I'm handsome. They won't hold me for ransom, cause I'm young and I'm rich and I'm handsome. Oh yeah, shake body. Oh yeah, move body. Make you ring alarm. Calema, sagacité, équilibré, faro tema, décalé, décalé, cricata, 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 pam, pam, somunto, somunto, calopere, calopere, calopere. All the blessings and love I decide, just they make me they shout hallelujah. I say all the blessings and love I decide, just they make me they shout hallelujah. Can't hold me for ransom, cause I'm young and I'm rich and I'm handsome. They won't hold me for ransom, cause I'm young and I'm rich and I'm handsome. Oh yeah, shake body.
Nice, good one, good one. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining us in studio. Morris, and of course, Scaled. Please start talking to us. The hashtag is #1on1. Once again, inviting you to give us your feedback, to talk to the fine gentlemen in studio. I'm surrounded by all this. Just me. How lucky do I get? Anyway, let me begin with you, Scales. Welcome to Kenya, Karibu.
Appreciate it.
Do you know how to say Asante?
Asante Sana.
Asante Sana. So Scales, that's your name. That's an acronym that stands for something.
It stands for Seek Knowledge Acquired Large Entrepreneurial Skills.
Seek knowledge
acquired large entrepreneurial skills.
Seek knowledge acquired large entrepreneurial skills. Nice. So your real name?
My real name is John Raul Injeng.
Mm-hmm.
That's my real name.
So you thought John was boring? Anyway.
No, as a matter of fact, I wanted to make it John Raul, but Scales was out there already, so I was like...
Yeah.
And I don't want to go through the process of, oh, you know what, let me change the name and stuff. And Scales is cool, man. Nobody has a name.
Yeah, that's a first, yeah. Morris, you decided to go with your birth name, I believe, as your stage name. So Morris Kiria, how has that been received? Just the fact, I mean, a lot of artists actually go with stage names, but you chose to just go with Morris.
Oh, I came up with many of those.
Yeah, such
a... I was in a group, we were a duo, and we used to do slow music, and we thought it was smart to call ourselves Too Slow. I'm glad we dropped that. I'm glad we dropped that wheel. And somehow I just kept going with my name.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So, Morris, let me start with you before I cross over to Scales. Your style of music is called Moyo, which I'm made to understand means soul.
Ugandan soul music.
Ugandan soul music. Tell us about your style of music.
I wanted to incorporate a lot of our very own traditional music with R&B and soul. And hip-hop, because that's what I grew up to. And over the years, I first released my first song in 1998. So over the years, I had the opportunity to keep messing and experimenting, and that's how I came about with that.
Okay. So, of course, we know Uganda for a certain beat, and I mean, this is arguable, but when you look at Radio and Weasel, when you look, just there's a certain beat, you know. You come in with this new style. How was that received at home?
7 years ago, it was quite hard. And people were still trying to understand what is it I was trying to do. But it's been received pretty well. I've seen so many very talented artists now doing that style, and that makes me really proud inside.
Okay. Yeah. And would you say, because I know that about 5 years ago you won a certain award. I know you're already doing your thing.
Yeah.
Tell us about that award. And do you think that catapulted you into fame today? Is that a fair statement?
I think every award kind of is a stepping stone to another. And everything has been very instrumental in my career. And the award was Radio France International, which saw me tour around the world and getting to wave the flag and also do music in different parts of the world. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay. And let me cross over, hold that thought, Morris, and talk to you as well, Scales. The similarity that you have with Morris is perhaps that you also won a Zane award. Why are you doing music before that award? Tell us about the award and what it did for you and your career.
Okay. Back then, I'll probably say I was really, really, really an underdog. So I just saw the advert on TV. I was like, okay, you know what? It's just close by the school, because I was in school back then.
Yeah.
I was like, let me just check it out. And I went first round. I passed.
Were you doing someone's song, or did you do one of your?
No, it was my song. Okay. I went through the first round, the second round, the third round, and the finals. I was there. And they announced that I was winning. I was like, yo, this was supposed to be a joke.
Yeah.
And I mean, it was all good. That was like the spark of the whole journey for me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, then I decided to, because I didn't used to stay in Lagos. I used to stay in like another state that was like 14 hours away from Lagos.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I had to move to Lagos because that's our own Hollywood, you feel me?
Yeah.
So that's where everything happens.
Uh-huh.
So after like a year, I got signed to EME.
Yes.
And after EME,
where you no longer are.
Yeah.
That has been a bit of a controversial issue.
Yeah, man, there's been, but it's fine, man, we're good, you know what I mean, because it was all in a mutual agreement, actually.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean, things weren't really working, so we decided to go our separate ways.
Mm-hmm.
And I started my own stuff. And, I mean, obviously, everybody can see that I'm shining now, so.
Yeah, and clearly no modesty, and why should you be? You are really,
yeah,
really,
yeah, as a matter of fact, I just did a concert on Sunday back in Lagos, and yo, the turnout was crazy, man. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It was unbelievable. It was star-studded.
Mm-hmm.
Even people that I did not invite came.
Yeah.
And I was shocked. So it was an amazing thing. I just dropped my album too.
Okay, so you are in Nairobi now. Is this your first visit? And in what capacity are you here? What are you here to do?
Okay, this is my second time actually in Nairobi. Well, I'm here for a party tomorrow, the Lagos night party at Skylux. And I'm also doing like a Nairobi version of my album release party.
Mm-hmm.
Alongside the
and
whole.
And you chose Nairobi?
Yeah, man, I love Nairobi. This,
yeah.
This is like the first African country before I move on to other places. But I love Nairobi a lot. This is like second home. I always feel at home when I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it's always fun. When I'm in some countries, I'm scared. But over here, I'm actually free. I mean, I hang around and chill here.
Okay. So, yeah. Good to know. So, Maurice, over to you. I want to talk about your music. I mean, you do. You said your style is, rather, your music. You call it Ugandan soul. So, what inspires your music? I know you sing a lot of beautiful songs to women, and you really seem to appreciate the female and her beauty and what have you, and love songs. But what do you sing about? What inspires your music?
This is going to sound a big cliche, but I would say what inspires me is life. With life, you have all these dynamics of different things.
Mm-hmm.
I like listening to people and hearing their stories and also sharing my experience.
Mm-hmm.
And in there, I find those topics that most people in songs will kind of ignore. The very little things that seem not important, they add up to something big. I like to tackle topics in a way that they haven't been tackled before. I like to find a new angle at everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And I know you also do a bit of acting, so
yes.
Just merging that with your music, how's that going for you?
It's a lot of work, but I'm thankful to my team and my managers. They're doing a good job. The acting takes a lot of time because you're on set from morning to evening. Right now we're working on a movie with Lupita Nyong'o in South Africa.
Nice.
In Uganda.
Okay,
so,
good to know.
Thanks. And so the schedule is crazy.
Tell us more about the movie. Is the title out yet? Is it a love story? Are you in a love story with Lupita?
I can't say much about it, but I can tell you the title of the movie is called The Queen of Katwe. It's a Disney movie.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been quite a busy schedule, but I've also had an opportunity to work on different movies. Two where I was the lead role.
Mm-hmm.
And I also was in the series The Hostel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you seem quite grounded. I've been at the Sound Cup, by the way. You're an
You have been? Yes, I do remember.
Morris runs a really nice restaurant. What do you call it? A coffee bar?
It's a cafe restaurant.
It's a cafe at Garden City.
At Garden City.
In Kampala. It's great. So you do that as well. The music, the acting, and
the restaurants, yeah.
Okay, so how is that going?
It's going pretty well. People have received it so well. And not only because it's mine, but because people love the service, the food, the presentation. And we also have performances there where we invite close to 300 people. We just feature artists from different places. We're actually planning on having Wadje there as well.
Wow.
From Nigeria. So it's pretty cool.
Okay, great. Let me turn. I mean, really, this conversation is all over the place, but I'll come back to you, Maurice. Scales. I want to talk about your style of music. Of course, you're coming into an industry that has Davido, you know, Banky W, Wizkid, all these big megastars. So for you to actually, and you know, we might be singing your songs here in Kenya, but maybe you're not a big deal in Nigeria. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm sure you are. But how do you, you know, penetrate and actually, you know, come out there solid, strong, and have people singing songs that, or dancing to songs that have actually given big megastars a run for their money?
I mean, it's quite easy, man, because I've been in this industry for, let's say, like eight years, basically, and stuff. So I kind of like have studied the market. I know what they want to hear. I know what to do, what kind of sound, when to switch sounds and stuff like that. So basically, I'll just say it's just focus, hard work, and I mean, being able to fit in whatever style you're trying to introduce, just fit it into what's going on. Mm-hmm. You get me? And basically, that's what I did. Like, you see Shake Buddy, there's no song like it in Nigeria. There's no song. Because that's a song I dropped, and honestly, effortlessly, I did not even push. Honestly, I didn't come to Kenya. I didn't go to South Africa. I didn't go nowhere. The song was big by itself.
Yeah, but how do you actually deal with not just being a one-hit wonder? Yeah. I mean, what's your strategy for that? Because we know people who have dropped mega hits. Yeah. They do really well. They're club bangers. And then after that, we never really hear or see anything from you again. Because, you know, I think the excitement sometimes gets to some artists. I might be wrong. But are you working on an album or on mega hits? And why do you guys even drop songs before you have an album completed?
Well, I feel like probably you just want to introduce people to what's coming ahead.
Okay.
So you just give them a taste of it. So if it's hit, a lot of people want to hear the album. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So that's like, in my case, that's the situation. Because, I mean, after Shake Buddy, I dropped like two other hits. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, I dropped two songs at the same day, on the same day. And the two of them are like topping chats right now in Nigeria and some countries I know and stuff like that. So
your relationship with Banky W, I know he reached
out. He's my homie, he's my mentor, you know what I mean? He kinda like paved the way for me in the industry. Mm-hmm. He signed me, he believed in me and Wizkid when nobody believed in us, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He was the first, should I say, the first CEO or the first artist to believe in young people that were lesser than 20.
Mm-hmm. You know, how old are you now?
I'm 24 now.
Okay.
He signed me and Wiz when Wiz was 18 when he signed him. He signed me when I was 17. Mm-hmm. Together and stuff like that.
And now that you brought up Wizkid, is your beef over? I saw your Twitter beef.
Yeah. I mean, that's really crazy. You know how, you know, I mean, you have siblings, you have family.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you always have bad days and you fall out and stuff like that. I guess we're both having a bad day, but I mean, we're working on it.
So what was the beef about? Clarify. Was it over a girl? Was it over somebody getting more attention?
I don't know. I don't know what it was, but it's just some crazy stuff that was going on.
Yeah.
But, I mean, all of us, we're making it right now, because I won't lie to you, if you call top five hottest artists right now in Nigeria, like, me and Wiz are there.
Yeah.
Point blank.
Okay,
you know,
good
so,
to know.
I mean, it's good that all of us are succeeding. I mean, but, you know what I mean, people do fall out. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
So you're not friends? Are you friends?
We're cool. We're trying to work things out now.
Okay, that means definitely the beef is not
we're gonna,
over.
It's not that long, you know what I mean? Yeah. But we're going to work on it, because we're working on it, actually, step by step. You know what I mean? It's not going to... It was a huge misunderstanding, because after then, we haven't seen each other at all.
Yeah.
We haven't been invited to the same show. Probably the promoters are scared or something. But I mean, we're good. If I see him today, trust me, I'll hug him and be like, yo, just let it go.
I hope he feels the same way.
Obviously.
But you've worked with Davido, so you're cool with Davido. And of course, your performances with him are amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, the energy is out of this world.
Yeah, man, Davido is a great dude, man. I mean, he's one really cool dude that people really need to understand, like, how blessed he is. He's someone that's so blessed. I mean, do you know what it is to have a rich father and you have a great career?
Yeah.
And I mean, he actually worked hard for his career, so he has a great career. He's like one of the coolest person ever.
Mm. You know? Yeah. Okay, good to know. Morris, I want to talk about your collabs. You've, of course, I haven't seen you do a lot with our Kenyan artists, but you've done something with Valerie Kimani.
Valerie, Aaron Rimboy.
Then why is it that Morris, I don't know, why are you not pushing your videos as much as you should back here at home, where we celebrate you so much? A lot of people play your music.
To be honest, that is true. I'm getting a lot of love from Kenya, and precisely the reason why I'm here, because I need to give back that love. I need to meet my Kenyan fans. I need to get to know them better. I need to make sure that they're getting the music. And it is true, because of the schedules, I didn't get a chance to really be out here. But since December, I feel like I've been more in Kenya than in Uganda, because of the numerous shows we've been doing here. And I see myself as this year I'll be able to reach more Kenyan fans and push more videos, because now the time is there and there's a new album, which is Moyo.
Okay.
And of course, I'm going to promote that. But not only that, I'm in works to do songs with the likes of Rabbit and Aaron again, and so many other artists. So I do know that I'm going to be able to reach a bigger fan base in Kenya than before.
Okay.
So that's going to change.
And let's talk about Coke Studio. By the way, Morris will be on Coke Studio, which will be airing right here on Citizen TV. So we're super excited about that.
Yeah.
Tell us about that. And you know, just you being in Coke Studio, you know, what that, of course, means for you and your career.
Yeah,
as well.
I think every artist should experience Coke Studio and what goes on there. I think it's the biggest show in Africa musically.
Yeah.
And working with the likes of Feed Q, who's from Tanzania, an amazing rapper, legend, actually. For me, it's a good opportunity not only to be a part of that creativity and artistry, but to also show Africa that we're the future. With Coke Studio, there's so much to show the world. The world can realize that there's artists who can do so many other things, because when we're there, we're not just singing the same style you're known for, you're actually showing how versatile you can be in different genres.
Okay, great. So, of course, Morris Kaya will be right here in Citizen TV a lot.
And
we're happy about that. And Scales, I want to talk about, of course, you and your collabos. First of all, who do you look up to internationally? Like, what artist for you really is like a music legend? And going forward, who would you like to collaborate with? I don't even know. Do you even know our music? You know, I keep asking every Nigerian artist that comes here whether you play our music. Back
yeah,
home.
Yeah,
you
we
don't.
Do. We do. We do.
A lot of them say no.
We do. As a matter of fact,
which song
funny
do you
enough,
know?
Funny enough, I just met Maurice here, and I actually know his song.
Really?
You get me? I didn't know he was the one until when they played the song. I was like, oh. You sang that song?
Yeah.
I really like that song, you feel me? Yeah. And of course, Southy Soul, they play Southy Soul a lot.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, they came to perform in Nigeria some time ago, and there's Stella Nwangi, there's Victoria Kimani.
Yes.
She's Nigerian, you know, because she has so many Nigerian friends, including myself.
Yeah.
We're always hanging. I mean, this is, who else? Okay, Camp Mola.
Mm-hmm. I mean, good. I'm glad to know that you know our, because, like I say, your music is all over our clubs. It would be nice to know that our music is being played out there
as well. Trust me.
And internationally, who is your music guru?
Kanye West, man. You know,
really?
I look, that guy is my hero. Basically, he's just someone whose lifestyle is, if you follow it, I mean, just pick the relevant ones, you get me?
Yeah.
The needed ones. Mm. If you follow it, trust me, you're going to head like, you're going to go like way up, you feel me? Because he's amazing. He's someone that's a genius. Mm-hmm. Trust me.
So what are people expecting from your show, Scales? What are the girls expecting from you?
I'm bringing that Lagos party out here, and I mean, I heard Kenyans love to party too.
Yeah.
So I mean, it's one Africa at the end of the day. So let's just turn up. Mm-hmm. Basically, let's turn up.
Yeah, and I'm sure there'll be that. Yeah. That's going down when tomorrow.
Tomorrow at Skylox.
Okay. Yeah. And of course, what projects are we expecting from you in the near future? Shake Body is huge in Nairobi right now.
Yeah,
what are we expecting from you?
Yeah, my album just dropped. As a matter of fact, I said I did a launch concert for it in Lagos. I have like Davido, Burna Boy, Victoria Kimani,
nice.
Ice Prince.
Wow.
A lot of people on it.
Is that a strategy on your part? The fact that you're collaborating with so many artists as opposed to just going it alone?
Honestly, the collabos happened like when we were, because most of these artists I featured are people that are really close to me, that people I chill with. So I just played like a couple of songs and then be like, oh, I like this one, I want to be on this one. I'll be like, no, I don't want you to be on this one. I want to be on this one, just me. Be on this one instead. Give me, that's how we just made the songs and stuff.
How
like
many
that.
Track albums?
Like 22, man.
Nice.
This is like my first album, actually.
Okay.
But first I needed to go in, and it's titled Man of the Year. Okay. It's on iTunes, by the way.
Uh-huh.
Of course, there's a lot of big things happening. There might be a remix for Shake Body with Major Lazer. I don't know if you know them.
Mm-hmm.
And they hit me up by themselves. Mm-hmm. And they really like the song and they want to do something, but I don't want to go deep in.
Kenyan artist that you'd like to do a collab with? Iyanya has done one with Jaguar. Iyanya has done one with Southeast. Okay, Iyanya has really been all over the place.
I'm cool to work with anybody that makes good music, man. Because I love good music, honestly.
Okay.
Give me anybody that's ready to do good music. Mm-hmm. Let's go, man. Let's do it, man.
All right. Good to know. Morris, for you, which Kenyan artist is really doing it for you? Like, who do you just listen to and go like, I want to work with this artist?
One of my all-time favorite Kenyan artists, that's Harry Kimani.
Yes, me too. Yes,
I could listen
amazing.
To his music all day. We've met before, and we definitely will work on something. Hopefully, if I can get to have a proper chat with him. But we're fans of each other's music, so when we met, we kind of had the same thing we had with Skills. Baxter just like, oh, I know that song. He's like, no, I know your song. No, I know this.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So I'm a big fan of of Harry Kimani. Yes, I am.
Okay. And finally, as we close, of course, talk to your fans and just, you know, a one-on-one with your fans. They never get this close to you guys. So, you know, your parting shots to your fans, Maurice.
Yeah, to all my fans all over Africa and everyone watching. I know there's people watching from Uganda as well. You got the tweet. I want to thank everyone that's following me and giving me love, and all the people in Kenya that have pushed me for all these years. Thank you so much. I got nothing but love for you. Thank you.
Good stuff. And from Mr. Scales himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm just too excited. You know what I mean? So, well, I want to say a big thank you for having me on the show first. Mm-hmm. I want to say a big thank you to Nairobi. You know what I mean? It's been fun. I don't feel like going back home, actually. I feel like just chilling here because I'm having so much fun. Well, please come join me tomorrow at Skylarks for the Lagos night. You know I mean, let's have fun tomorrow. And of course, if you want to get to me, you can reach me through Twitter. My name is Young Skills on Twitter. On Instagram, my name is Young Skills. Snapchat, Young Skills. YouTube, Young Skills. I'm not on Facebook, but I have a fan page. You can follow me there for news on anything new that I'm about to drop. You know I mean, and of course, man, I mean, Skills, baby.
Good stuff. Well, that's all the time we had. And of course, every Friday right here, it gets better, it gets bigger. Internationally renowned stars only get, well, not only, but I mean, like, get to actually share the red couch with me here, and it's amazing. It gets bigger every other Friday. Thank you so much for your time, and keep talking
to us. By the way, you're very beautiful.
Sorry?
You're very beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Oh.
Don't blush too much.
Thank you. You just made my day. You don't think I'm beautiful?
You should
have seen this Ugandan.
We have a lot to talk about right after you. Because I'll need more than 30 minutes to just explain everything.
Vanity for
days. Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much for coming. That's all the time we had. Hashtag is #1on1. Keep talking to us. Good night.